Redemption was the only hospital free for population, free and public. And so it was very important for poor communities and the slums who lived around, actually. And nobody could go there, and nobody could have access to health facilities. So it was complicated for population, not because of Ebola only, but also because for all kind of disease and for maternity, there was no access to health. At the end of the management of Ebola in this hospital, it was not properly done. They used to throw waste wherever they could, and actually it was not so good. So they lost control, and finally they decided to close. You can see it's like people have disappeared suddenly. These places, you could see clothes of people, personal effects, and you could see that they had closed in panic. We had waste destruction by incineration knowledge, and we had the machines also, and we trained on PPE, on personal equipment for Ebola, to clean. We had cleaners and cleaning knowledge to do that. Actually, nobody wanted to move Ebola waste from the contaminated area to a burning place or a landfill, so we had to burn on site. It was quite complicated because on site you needed people in PPE, which is sensitive for health and viral security, and then you need also people, operators, who know incineration, and this is also very technique because there is a heat, and people who wear PPEs, they are with plastics. If they are too close from the incinerator, plastic can melt. It can be very dangerous for staff. Some of cleaners, they lost actually relatives. And probably his commitment came also for that. And instead of staying and to be scared, they decided to go ahead, to live and to fight Ebola. And for them, it's like a revenge, more or less. And actually, when you see these people, it's very motivating. And finally, you do the job for them.